同学们，我们又见面了。How are you today? I'm very happy because I can see you again. 老师今天很高兴，因为啊，我又和大家见面了。Do you read books at home? Do you do sports at home? 你们在家里有没有每天坚持阅读？有没有在家里做运动呢？我们的课程当中啊，专门设置体育锻炼这一环节。Rebecca 也跟大家一起跟着这些律动，跟着老师一起做运动，在家里也别忘了要运动哦。OK，And do you read English every day？你们在家里每天都有没有读英语呢？每天读英语15分钟，你们会发现啊。自己的英语真的是一天一天进步，看得见。OK，let's begin our lesson today. Do you remember what do we learn last lesson? 你们还记得上节课我们学了什么内容吗？上节课我们学了 comparative degree，比较级。我们学习了要让两者进行比较，我们可以使用。这个句型进行比较。be 动词加比较级，再加 then 来进行连接。OK，now today we are going to learn. Let's learn. 今天我们要学习。整个单元的词汇。OK，before we learn the new knowledge, let's have a look our learning aims. 来看看我们的学习目标吧。一、掌握本单元的词汇。二、理解形容词比较级规则变化。三、运用形容词的比较级。Have you got it? Okay, now let's go. Let's warm up. Firstly, let's play again. Let's say the words as fast as you can. 我们啊，一起来快速的说单词吧。Are you ready? Go! Now, let's practice. 我们现在就来试着描述一下他们吧。They are Yao Ming and Liu Xiang. Let's see. Can you see? Yes, Yao Ming is tall. Liu Xiang is short. What about this word? Yao Ming is big. Yeah, he has a big build. 他是个大个子嘛。Yes, Liu Xiang is small. You're right, Yao Ming is strong. Liu Xiang is thin. Great, Liu Xiang is strict. Yao Ming is strict because Yao Ming is a coach. Yao Ming 是个教练, so he is very strict. Yeah, and Liu Xiang is kind. OK, 在之前我们5年级的时候，我们只能够使用相反的两个词。来进行比较，那么我们通过学习的形容词的比较级就不需要那么麻烦了。OK，so what is comparative degree？什么是形容词的比较级呢？Let me show you examples. Let's go. Look, here comes two minions. 来了两个小黄人。Let's see. Hello, everyone. I'm Bob. I'm 30 centimeters tall. 大家注意看，这里有一个新的单位出现了，centimeters。 厘米 Follow me. Centimeters. 三十厘米 30 centimeters. 30 centimeters. Okay, let's see another line. Hi, I'm Kevin. I'm 70 centimeters tall. So, you can see, Bob is short. Kevin is tall. But, can you answer my question? Who is taller? Taller has two parts. Tall and er means 更高的. Okay.Think about my question. Who is taller? 谁更高呢? You're so clever. Kevin is taller. Kevin is taller than Bob. Please read out me. 请跟 Rebecca 一起读. Kevin is taller. Kevin is taller.Then Bob. Okay. Please answer my another question. 请回答我另外一个问题。Who is shorter? Shorter has two parts. Short and er means 更矮的。谁更矮呢? Can you speak out? 你们能说出来吗?You're right. Bob is shorter. Bob is shorter than Kevin. Now please read after Rebecca. Bob is shorter. Bob is shorter than Kevin. Excellent. Now let's see another example. Let's see the picture. Wow. They are...Sisters, 她们是冰雪奇缘里的姐妹花，还记得吗? They are Elsa and Anna. So, here comes my question. Who is older and who is younger? Think about it and speak out. 想一想，和你旁边的爸爸妈妈说一说。Excellent!Elsa is older. Elsa is older than Anna. Please read after me. Elsa is older. Elsa is older than Anna. So who is younger? You're right. Please follow me. Anna is younger.Anna is younger than Elsa. Wow, I think you can read very well. Now, boys and girls, please see it. You can see tall, add er becomes taller. Tall 加 er 直接变成了更高的。What about this word? Do you remember?你们记得它们应该怎么变吗? Let's see together. Okay, let's speak out. 我们一起把它说出来。Shorter, older, younger. Wow. Please open your shut eyes. Can you find out the common points? 它们有什么相同之处呢?You're right. They all have the same ending, er. So, we can get. We usually add er after the adjectives to become comparative degree word. 我们可以在形容词的后面加 er, 以此让它变成较级，我相信很多同学已经在用笔记本记录下来了，对吗？Excellent. Now, cartoon. Let's learn together. Let's see a cartoon, try to find out the comparative degree words.
观看动画，来找一找这些形容词的比较级吧。Go!
How tall are you? I'm 1.61 meters. Oh, I'm taller. You're older than me too.
Younger? Younger.
Older? Older.
Taller? Taller.
Shorter? Shorter.
Shorter? Shorter.
Longer? Longer.
Okay, have you got it? Now, please answer my question. Now, please answer my first question. Who is taller between John and John Hong? Can you find out? Yeah, you can see it clear. We know Zhang Peng is taller. Zhang Peng is taller than John. So, what about John? Can you describe it? You're right. John is shorter. John is shorter than Zhang Peng. Okay, let's see two girls, Amy and Chen Jie. What differences between Amy and Chen Jie? Can you find out them? You're right. Amy's skirt is shorter. Her skirt is shorter than Chen Jie's. And Chen Jie's skirt is longer. Her skirt is longer than Amy's. 我们进行比较时，不光可以拿两个人物进行比较，也可以使用两个人物的物品。这个时候我们就要使用所有格，像刚刚我们使用的 Amy's. Okay, boys and girls, let's read after the recorder. Pay attention. Try to imitate your pronunciation and your intonation. 一定要注意模仿语音语调。Let's go.
How tall are you? I'm 1.61 meters.Oh, I'm taller. You're older than me, too.
Younger.
Older.
Taller.
Shorter.
Shorter.
Longer.
Wow, excellent!I think you can read them very well. 我们刚刚知道了，我们可以在形容词后加 er 来变比较级。那么形容词的比较级只有这一种变化方法吗？同学们想一想，和你的家人讨论一下。很多同学都说好像不止这一种变化方法吧。 OK, let's see a video. 我们来看一段有趣的视频，你们就会知道了。 Let's go.
没有高铁的风驰电掣，我们还会对老牛货车无动于衷。没有别人家的学霸小孩，妈妈也不会对我的成绩单唉声叹气。没有比较，我们这个世界该多么无聊。因为跟着比较级也是丰富多彩的。英语中的比较级，让我们熟知的形容词摇身一变，成为更有魅力的存在。想要知道英语中的比较级怎么形成的吗 ？Follow me。一般情况，我们只需要在单词后面直接加 er 就好。然而，记住先强的字母 e 绝不允许有第二个 e 存在。如果这个单词结尾已经有了一个 e， 那 就必须绝情地踢走他的伙伴E。古时候有个叫曹冲的小孩，特别喜欢用船来称东西，英语 Oh my god Harry。 小样，想和我一样变成比较级，先把 Y 变成 I， 再加个小尾巴一二吧。元音字母是英语世界里最受欢迎的人物。当一个单词是辅音加元音加辅音的结构时，他们都舍不得离开彼此呢。这个时候，结尾的辅音字母只好变出一个分身，再去和小尾巴一二在一起了。小尾巴人人都爱，可凡事皆有。
Okay, have you got it? Wow, so there are so many rules. 其实是有很多很多的规律的。Let's have a look. 形容词比较级的规则变化。现在请同学们准备好笔记本。Rebecca 要给大家讲解了。第一条我们已经知道了，就是直接在单一节词末尾加一二。那么第二条有一点点难度。细看，单音词如果以 e 结尾的话，我们只要直接加 r 就可以了。刚刚我们通过视频也已经知道了 e， 它可是不允许另外一个 e 的存在哦。我们来看一看 nice 这个词，它就是以 e 结尾，因此直接加 r。 Read up me nicer. OK, let's see another wordFine, 它也是以 e 结尾，我们要怎么变比较级呢？ Excellent, 直接加 r, follow me, finer. Let's see, large, 巨大的。 Large 这个词应该怎么变比较级呢？ Larger, excellent.这是第二种变化，同学们，你们记好了吗？我们接下来看第三种变化，这个变化有一点点难度哦，但是老师相信这难不倒你们。第一节单音词末尾只有一个辅音字母，需双写这个辅音字母加一二。很多同学就问了 ，Rebecca， 什么叫闭音节的词呢？很简单。Let's have a look. 闭音节指的是辅音加一个元音字母，再加一个辅音字母。符合这样的结构都是闭音节。其中的元音 ，Rebecca 用红色标注出来。元音可是非常重要的。我们要学好英语，首先就得记住有哪些是元音字母，剩下的就是辅音字母。26个字母当中，只有五个元音字母。分别为，大家大声朗读出来 ，A E I O U， very good。那么除了这五个元音字母，其余的都是辅音。那么 Rebecca 给大家举个例子，比如说 big，B 是辅音字母 ，I 是元音 ，G 辅音，这样就是一个闭音节。OK，Let's、okay, see，big。要变成比较级的话，我们得双写 G 加一二。Follow me, bigger. Let's see another one. Thinner. Have you got it? 同学们，你们记好了吗？大家来看第四点，以 Y 结尾，如果 Y 的前面是辅音字母，则变 Y 改 I 加一二。比如说 heavy 这个词，我们来看一看 ，y 的前面是辅音字母 v， 因此变比较级。Follow me, heavier. Happy. Okay, let's see another cartoon.
How heavy are you, Jim? I'm 52 kilograms.You're heavier than me.
Thinner.
Heavier.
Bigger.
Smaller. Smaller.
Stronger. Stronger.
Okay, have you got it? Now, boys and girls, let's answer my question. Who is heavier than John and Jane? You can see it clear. 可以很清楚地看到。Jane is heavier. Jane is heavier than John. So, whose shoes are bigger? Mike's or Wu Yifan's? Yeah, 我们可以通过单词找到。We know Mike's shoes are bigger than Wu Yifan's. And Wu Yifan's shoes are smaller than Mike's. Okay, let's read after the recorder.
How heavy are you, Jim?
I'm 52 kilograms.
You're heavier than me.
Thinner.
Heavier.
Bigger.
Smaller.
Stronger.
Wow. 同学们这几种变化你们都掌握了吗？Okay, boys and girls. Let's see. Let's do a survey and report. 现在请你们和身边的家长一起来完成这个小练习。It's a survey. 这是一个调查。我们需要询问你父母或者你的姐妹、你家人他们的 age, height, and weight.使用句型把他们的身高体重记下来哦。Here is a tips for you. 老师给大家一个小小的贴士。You shouldn't ask a lady age. 我们不要去问一个女士的年龄，哪怕她是你的妈妈。Okay, if you want to ask me, how old are you, Rebecca? I just tell you, it's a secret. 你们问我年龄的话我只会说 is a secret. Okay. Have you finished? Okay. Here is the practice time. 老师来检测一下你们今天的学习了。Now firstly, let's wrap it up. 大家把这些单词的比较级写下来吧。 Okay, have you got it? 这些单词刚好检测我们刚刚学习的形容词比较级的规则变化。Let's check the answers. 你们检查一下自己都写对了吗？ Now, please read after me. 请跟 Rebecca 一起来读一读吧。Long, longer.Strong, stronger. Big, bigger. Sad, sadder. Hot, hotter. 在这里 big, sad, hot 是双写末尾的辅音加一二。我们来看第二排吧。Angry, angrier. Sunny.Sunnier, funny, funnier, happy, happier, windy, windier. 这一排全是 辅音字母加 y 结尾，所以把 y 改 i 加 er。你们都写对了吗？瑞贝卡相信啊，你们一定会把它完正确的写完，因为这对你们来说并不难，对吗 ？OK， 我们来做另外一道练习吧。根据首字母的提示补全单词。做这道题之前，瑞贝卡给大家一点小提示：我们在写的时候，一定要先把句子的意思读完整。瑞贝卡带大家来做第一道题 ：One, the dog is 一个 S 开头的单词 ，then the horse 狗和马来比较。哎，他们在比什么呢？而且是一个 S 开头的单词。同学们，开动小脑袋瓜，想一想。对了，他们在比大小，所以这个词应该填 smaller。OK， 同学们可以根据 Rebecca 的这个方法来做下面的四道小题。记住，先把题读完整。OK, have you finished? One, the monkey's tail is longer than the rabbit's. Two, you're right. Amy is younger than Miss White. Three, the woman is older than the girl.Four, the giraffe, 长颈鹿, is taller than the deer. Wonderful, boys and girls, you can read very well. 老师相信啊，你们一定都掌握了。Now, let's have a look. 我们来进入 summary 课堂小结的环节，一起来回顾一下我们今天学了什么吧。In my class today, we learned the comparative degree. 我们继续学习了形容词的比较级。我们来把这四种变化一起再来回顾一遍。形容词比较级的规则变化，在单音词的末尾直接加一二。如果单音词以一结尾，则直接加二。闭音节单词末尾只有一个辅音字母，需双写这个辅音字母，加一二。以 y 结尾单词，如果 y 前面是辅音字母，则变 y 改 i 加一二。你们的笔记都记好了吗？如果没有记好，现在赶紧还可以把它补充一下。OK， 在下一节课当中，我们将要继续学习比较级。老师希望呢，我们一起好好的把今天学的内容熟记。第一项作业。熟悉形容词比较级的四种规则变化。二，请大家规范抄写今天学的词汇。三，请对家人进行访谈。Okay, thank you for listening. You are so working hard. 同学们一定学得非常的认真。Thank you. See you next time. Goodbye.